Hey, how's it going, everybody? This is Kevin from Audio Digital. Today, I'm here to let you know about a website I found out about called Converse Rubber Tracks Sample Library. It's at converse-sample-library.com. This is really cool. I was really happy when I found out about it. It's basically a collection of all kinds of samples, one-shots, loops, stems, that were recorded at the studio by various different musicians, and they're arranged in these packs for each band or musicians that created them. They're all high quality and they're all free to use, whether for commercial or whatever applications. So I highly recommend you check it out. There's a pretty good size. There's a pretty good amount of samples and materials to work with. And I'm just going to show you how the site works real quick. So when you first come to the site, you'll come into the packs section. And you have all these little cool, little squares here. And each one is a different musician. And if you click on one of these, you can hear what kind of music and what style we're dealing with here. And so if you like that, let's go in here and see what this person's about. There's a little video of the person, and there's like one shots that you can trigger here. And you can trigger loops. So you might wonder, how do I download this stuff? If you come up to the top, there's a browse files. It tells you how many files are under this pack. You click there, and this little icon right here allows you to download. Over here to the left, you can filter for specific criteria. If you just want keyboard and no bass, for instance, and then you want things that are in C major or whatever, you can isolate those and get exactly what you want, which is pretty nice. And then you can still sample it from here. And you can, of course, favorite things, and then you can access it at different times if you don't want to download it immediately or whatever. Now, another real cool thing about this whole setup is that there's kits that you can set up. So if you look under kits, these are kits that other users have put together, and you can click on them and trigger things. And if you look, if you mouse over the kit, it gives you the letters on your keyboard that you can use to trigger it. So you can just...
Yeah.
So that's real fun. You can just go right in and start playing stuff. You can also, while you're in the pack section and you're looking at some stuff, let's try this, whatever. You can actually create your own kits by just dragging and dropping things into a new kit. So here's a new kit I haven't put. I put this stuff here from before. But if I want to, like if I like this guitar loop, I can just drag and drop it, and then I can trigger it with the key. So you can have a lot of fun with this stuff. And then when you want to use it in a production, if you have Ableton Live, there's actually a plugin you can use that will allow you to access all of the material. There's actually an iPhone app, and then there's also this plugin that you can use in Ableton Live. I don't use Ableton, and if you're not using Ableton, you can still get stuff into your productions pretty easy. You just click on one of these kits, and then you can click download, and it'll download it to your computer, and then you can just unzip it, basically extract it, because it's going to be a zip file. And once you get this extracted file here, you can just grab these guys and go into your DAW, like Bitwig here. And let me just get back to you. Wait, sorry. Here we go. Let's go back here. So I just need to access these files here. Just drag and drop them into Bitwig, and boom. So it gets that to be that easy just to start putting a beat down with it. Anyway, so you can see it's really easy to start messing with stuff and just putting some things together. And it's really nice because you can get inspired in ways that you ordinarily wouldn't. Even if you have your own sample banks, you probably have things that you are used to using, or loops that you're used to using. Myself, I don't really use a lot of loops. So for me, kind of coming in and just looking at some of the crazy stuff they have here, and then just thinking about, oh, how could I use that in a production, or how could I, you know, modulate that or cut it up and reuse it. And it really helps to get the juices flowing, the creative juices flowing. So anyway, that's how you use this guy, and I hope you enjoy it. I hope you try it out. Stop all audio. See, that's the stop all audio button, so that's pretty cool too. I hope you try it out, and I'm glad that you watched this video. Thanks a lot for doing so. Subscribe if you haven't already. And everyone, please just enjoy being creative. Thank you so much, guys. Bye.